Hello, my name is Mark Renz. I'm with the University of Wisconsin-Madison, and I'm an extension specialist. I'm here to talk to you today about how to calibrate a sprayer. And this is where we're using a ATV or UTV sprayer for natural areas or other hard to reach areas. This is something that isn't done quite often, but it really can have benefits, and we really recommend trying to calibrate multiple times a year if possible. And there's lots of other videos and other assistance on how to do this, but it gets really complicated with equations and other things, and we're really going to try and simplify it here for you in this video, where all you need is something to measure your output, tape measure to measure the width of your boom, and a timer and a smartphone to help with conversions. Now, calibration is really important because you want to know the right amount that you're applying per unit area. We're going to calculate gallons per acre of output of this material, of this sprayer. And it's really important so we can understand how much is putting out, so we can help us when we know how much to mix and ensure we're putting out the right amount of product per acre. Realize if we're putting too little out, it might not perform as well as we would like. And if we're putting too much out, it might injure some of the species that we think are tolerant to this. A great example is milestone or aminopyrrolid. If we go above the label rate, we can injure those grasses, which are typically safe. And most importantly, it's the law. We're legally required to apply specific amounts of these products per acre. And if we go over that, we're breaking the law. Some labels will have percent solutions to help with mixes, but still we're required to know how much per unit area we're putting out. And so that's what we're going to go through today. We're going to go through three simple steps on what you need to know in order to make this calculation. The first step is we're going to know what the width of our spray boom is here. The second step is we're going to calculate how much is being put out by each nozzle or for that whole spray boom. And then the final one, which is actually harder than you think, is we're going to show you how to estimate the speed or how fast you're traveling when you're making those applications. And then we're going to bring those all together in calculations to estimate the output of this sprayer in gallons per acre, and that will help you with all of the stuff that we just talked about. So let's get going and calculate first step one. Okay, I'm here with Tom Wise with the Nature Conservancy, and we're gonna do the first step in determining what the spray width is that we're actually spraying. Realize we have seven nozzles here and they're all about 20 inches apart. And realize that these nozzles have to overlap. So in order for us to determine and measure the effective spray width, we have to measure out half the distance from the edge of that last nozzle. So Tom's gonna help me here and put that sprayer out. And we're gonna measure all the way over. And what we see is the effective spray width is 144 inches or 12 feet. That's the important first piece of information to use in this calculation. Okay, the next step is a little bit more tricky, but it's actually not that bad. Really what we're gonna use in this case is a graduated cylinder and a timer. I'm gonna use my smartphone too. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna determine how much each nozzle is putting out in a 10 second time frame. So we have it running and going. I'm gonna start my timer and put it underneath and for 10 seconds. And when that 10 seconds is up, I'm gonna pull it out and estimate how much that volume is. So it's a good idea to check multiple nozzles just to make sure that they're all working and not worn or clogged. They should be within 5% to make sure you have a good spray pattern. Okay, you can see that's pretty easy. We ended up in this case with 130 milliliters in 10 seconds. Now we're gonna repeat that on all these nozzles to come up with how much each one is putting out, and hopefully it's within 5%, and that'll allow us to make our next step in the calculation. Okay, so the third and final important piece of information is the speed that we're traveling. And a lot of these have speedometers, but you really can't trust them. So what you want to do is try and practice the speed you think you're going to travel in your area. And then you want to measure out a specific area so we can determine what that speed is. So what I've done here is we've measured out 50 square feet. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have Tom drive at his expected speed, and we're going to actually measure the distance, the speed traveled, and we're gonna measure it in seconds per 50 feet. So we're gonna have Tom go ahead and go, and I'm gonna hit start when he hits the zero part.
Okay.
As you can see, it took us almost 9 seconds to travel 50 feet. It's always a good idea to do this a couple times to make sure that your speed is accurate and it's going to be the appropriate speed you want to take in that terrain. Okay, so now that we've completed our 3 steps, what we found out is the width of this boom is 12 feet. We've also determined the output of this spray boom. Each nozzle was giving us between 150 and 160 milliliters in 10 seconds. If you add up the number of milliliters across those 7 nozzles that come and divide that by 10, that comes out to 108.5 milliliters per second. And then we measured the distance traveled and the time it took, and we found that in 9 seconds, we were able to travel 50 feet. That's 0.18 seconds per feet. Now the magic is we need to use all of that information to convert it into gallons per acre. We're going to show you in another video how to do that, but using our calculations, that comes out to a little over 17 gallons an acre, which is right about where we typically want to be, between 15 and 30 gallons per acre for this spraying unit. So as you can see, this approach is pretty simple. It uses technology to help us get an understanding of what the output of these ATV and UTV sprayers are, so we can better understand how much pesticide we're putting out on the landscape and make sure we're applying it safely and correctly to get our desired results. We'll have a lot more information and links to other resources in this video. So good luck and happy spraying.